Wynn, Arkansas is known as the city with a smile, and it's home to a woman who manages to smile against all the odds.
I've actually had somebody come up to me and ask if I've been in a fire and want to pray for me.
Stephanie has Harlequin ichthyosis, a rare genetic disease which causes her skin to be abnormally thick and severely cracked. Stephanie cannot grow much hair. Her ears and eyelids are receded, and the disorder has caused deformities to her hands and feet. Survival rate at birth is 50%, as babies with the condition normally die within a few days through infection.
They told me babies that are born with this skin condition just don't live. I mean, there was no hope.
Against the odds, Stephanie, at 23 years old, has survived to become the oldest living female in America with Harlequin ichthyosis, but she's struggled her whole life with the condition.
If it was too hot, I would have to stay in. I'd get sick, and like pus and stuff would, you know, come up, and my skin would hurt, and it would be awful.
The cracked skin of those with Harlequin ichthyosis is prone to bacteria and potentially fatal infection. Constant protection is required.
I think it's like a barrier, pretty much is the best way I know how to describe it, to keep the germs out.
The cream also lubricates Stephanie's tight skin to help her move her restricted limbs.
I now spend about 15 minutes putting lotion on because my skin is so tight and it doesn't have any give on it or anything.
But Stephanie is philosophical about her condition.
Like this, my skin is all I've ever known. It's just this, you know, just born like this. I've always had it. So I didn't really look at myself any differently.
Look at this,
With encouragement from her mother, Stephanie is determined to live a normal life.
Right, Mama, come get it, boy. Come get it.
Stephanie's courageous lust for life eventually led her to finding romance with Mr. Wright.
Whenever I met her, I didn't see somebody that had a skin disorder. I just seen a beautiful woman who was funny, and she's always trying to make things positive.
The couple had a whirlwind marriage, and soon Stephanie became pregnant.
It looks beautiful. I like this.
I've always wanted to be a mom, but I didn't know if I could actually have kids.
I mean, I'm just glad he married you.
The big fear was whether the skin on Stephanie's stomach would stretch as she grew bigger during pregnancy.
I was terrified for her to have babies. It's not worth having a grandbaby to lose my baby.
A person with Harlequin ichthyosis giving birth was unprecedented.
Yeah, little alpha. We talked to doctors, but they knew nothing. They couldn't tell us anything because I was the first one to have, you know, to even really consider having a baby.
In her determination to be a mother, Stephanie was taking a huge risk. If she survived, she would be making history. Determined to become a mother, Stephanie went ahead, and against all expectations, pregnancy was beneficial for her rare skin condition.
The pregnancy was wonderful. I had so much energy. My skin was doing like way better.
Stephanie became the first ever Harlequin ichthyosis sufferer to give birth.
Hey, you're running over the monkey.
She had a healthy baby boy, Willie, now age 2.
You're running over me.
Followed by Olivia, aged 4 months. Neither child was born with Harlequin ichthyosis, as both parents must have the genetic defect for it to be passed on to their children.
I can't tell you what good of a feeling it is just to see your baby healthy and happy.
Both Stephanie's parents were carriers of the gene that causes Harlequin ichthyosis, but fortunately her husband Curtis is not.
Stephanie is a super mom. She can be doing 50 different things at once and still have enough time to smile, still have enough time to take care of both the kids.
You're so beautiful.
But post-pregnancy, Stephanie still faces the worst of her condition, as constantly broken skin leaves her body prone to infections.
I've seen her to the point where trying to get up out of bed is a challenge that most people wouldn't be able to accept.
Stephanie will always have a severely debilitating illness, but she possesses one of life's most important assets, a capacity for hope.
I hope the future holds nothing but happiness. Well, I'm sure there'll be a few little bumps along the way, but I mean, that's life. We're just focusing on my two perfect babies that I have now and my wonderful husband. And that's basically it, just living life.
Padua is a picturesque city in northern Italy that's steeped in ancient history. It's a city that could be described as both elegant and impressive, much like one of its inhabitants. Julia, age 23, is a part-time fashion model and aspiring politician. But Julia started life with the odds stacked against her.
Perché io non mi reputo diversa, io non sono diversa. Io sono forse speciale, forse particolare, ma...
She was born with parts of her hands and feet missing and a cleft palate, leaving doctors baffled by her condition.
Presero questa bimba e la portarono via immediatamente, coprendola, senza dirmi nulla.
It was a difficult time for Julia's mother.
Quando ti dicono che il tuo figlio ha un problema e non sei preparato, rimani semplicemente basito davanti a questa informazione che ti viene data.
Doctors eventually diagnosed Julia with a rare genetic disorder called EEC syndrome.
Ed è l'alterazione genetica di un gene, si chiama P63, a livello del palato, delle dita, delle mani e dei piedi.
Since birth, Julia has had 20 operations to correct deformities of her hands, feet and mouth. But other problems still persist.
Nel mio caso, la sindrome C ha colpito con la mia mutazione in modo molto grave gli occhi. Nel momento in cui sono arrivata alla quasi alla cecità, ci vedo un ventesimo, che è un quarto di decimo, quindi un livello visivo molto, molto basso.
Julia continues to hope for a solution to her eye problem, but another issue is her partially formed hands. Although she's had several surgeries since birth, today, Julia will see a doctor because she's having trouble gripping with her left hand.
Quindi il nostro obiettivo è quello di rilasciare proprio questi cordoni cicatriziali con delle tecniche che si chiamano plastica Z. Incideremo qua, fine sul tuo cordone. Tu avrai un zigzag.
Today's consultation has gone well, and Julia will be having her 21st surgery tomorrow.
È andata molto bene, quindi per riuscire ad avere la massima estensione possibile e una buona chiusura anche della mano, adesso avrò circa un mese e mezzo di riabilitazione che partono dal messaggio.
Despite ongoing difficulties with her condition, Julia's strength of character is unwavering. Today, she's hosting a networking event for a charity set up by her mother to help EEC syndrome sufferers worldwide.
Cerchiamo di organizzare una volta ogni 2 o 3 anni dei meeting internazionali per dare l'informazione alle famiglie, ai genitori e ai ragazzi con sindrome C.
Buonasera a tutti e grazie. Grazie di essere qui.
Julia and her mother's charity has received donations and has attracted membership from all over the globe. It has the recognition and support of top medical practitioners. Perhaps none of this would have been possible without Julia's courage.
Penso che la mia presenza all'interno dell'associazione sia una testimonianza concreta e diretta di quella che può essere la qualità di vita di una persona con una patologia rara. La mia vita è spumeggiante, è colorata, è bellissima, non cambierei assolutamente niente di quello che sono io.